I'm Suzanne LeMignot. Here are the stories making headlines at this hour. A 13-year-old boy and a pregnant woman are shot in a drive-by shooting in Little Village. Both are recovering in the hospital. The gunfire missed two other children sitting in a car near 28th and Lawndale. Police do not have anyone in custody. Chicago police say targeted efforts to fight violent crime are working, with double-digit drops in nearly every category over the past 2 years. Moments ago, Superintendent Eddie Johnson told us he's pleased with the progress, but there's more work that needs to be done.
It's not room for celebration, but personally, I'm encouraged. You know, we put three strategies in place that I think are contributing to that. You know, one is the technology that we've invested in. You know, number two is the hiring plan. You know, so by the time we're done with this, we'll be at about 1,000 officers more than we were when we started. And then the third thing is the community relationships that we built over the last couple of years. You know, so we just have to keep doing that.
Now, so far this year, police have investigated 311 murders. That's a 20% decline from 2016. 1,600 people were shot. Now, while that number sounds astounding, it's actually 30% less than 2 years ago. So far this year, officers have taken 5,400 guns off the streets. Today, five new ambulances will hit the streets of Chicago. The city stepped up the announcement just hours after a two investigators' report found serious delays in response times. Now, in one case, a heart attack victim waited 24 minutes for an ambulance. That's four times longer than the recommended six-minute standard. Chicago's fire commissioner says that case is under investigation and more ambulances will help.
Do you think with these five ambulances that you have enough to reduce the excessive response times to what they should be?
These five ambulances are going to create a very positive impact on this system. It will address response times.
Now, even with these new ambulances, Chicago ranks last among the five largest U.S. cities in terms of how many ambulances there are per 100,000 people. Meteorologist Megan Glaros has your forecast.
Yeah, we'll be topping out around 85 degrees today, but we'll be dealing with some showers developing as early as about 2 o'clock, generally on the lake breeze, so they'll be a little bit closer to the city, right around the immediate lakefront. Couple scattered showers out to the west of that, but still dealing with rain even at about 5:30 and continuing on to 7:30, still a couple of showers. Now, once the sun sets, the rain is pretty much over. We're looking for rainfall estimates that show it could be a little bit of a heavy thunderstorm at times. Not expecting severe weather, but looking for upwards of maybe as much as 1 inch in a heavier storm that could possibly develop a little bit later on today. Lollapalooza, it's getting hot. We've got a chance of showers and storms out there on our Thursday for the first day of Lollapalooza, 86 degrees, but take a peek at the weekend. Temps go all the way up into the 90s.
All right, Megan, thanks. Keep it right here on CBS Chicago for updates throughout the day.